just what the past week has been like and getting ready after that game you had?
It's kind of surreal. It's an amazing opportunity for me and the team to keep moving forward, keep getting better, keep winning games.
When Keenan went down, what was your initial reaction?
It's a shame. It hurts to see anybody on the team get hurt in any way, shape, or fashion. But it's a great opportunity for me to grow and for this team to get better.
And to walk away from that game, I mean, was there a point where, like, I can't believe that just happened? It was an incredible night for you.
Yeah, I mean, every week I prepare to be the starter, and it just so happened to be that I had to go out there and perform. So it wasn't anything new to me. I've seen you know, crazier things happen, and it was a great team win.
Have you gotten any cool text messages from any of the alumni or anyone reach out that was pretty cool?
No, I think the coolest thing is just going to see my family after the game, see their emotions, and getting to hug them.
I saw it. Was that your dad here at practice?
Yeah.
What was his reaction to your performance?
He's speechless. Same thing with my family, or my mom and my other siblings. So.
Have you
rewatched
the
post game show yet?
No, I haven't. No. They talked to me about it, but I haven't watched it myself.
Talk about having opportunity. I know coaches talk about having competition always. You come into this opportunity thinking, you know, I might be able to win the starting job going forward. Is that a thought that you have?
Of course, yeah. No, every day is a great opportunity, especially today. It sucks to see, you know, anyone on the team get hurt, but that leaves more opportunity and more doors open for myself. So I'm going to go ahead and take that and run with it.
What do you have to improve on from last week?
I have a lot of things to improve on just in general. I think, you know, obviously I got to work on my deep ball. I got to work on my reads. I got to work on, getting better trust with the receivers and the alignment and the running back. So there's a lot of aspects of the game.
What are you kind of expecting from that Washington defense?
We're expecting the same thing from BYU. Play a lot of, you know, drop eight, cover deep ball, but, you know, they could switch it up on us. They could blitz us. They could play man. It doesn't, you know, we don't really know, but we're preparing for any situation.
Man, we're even seeing Michael Pittman kind of take his game up a notch this season.
I mean, the guy is—he's a tremendous athlete, teammate, and brother. Every day he comes out here with a chip on his shoulder, and he strives to get better. And that's why he's a captain on the team, and that's why he's you know, one of the best athletes on the team as well.
You said Washington will go to Sanger coverage. What do you got to do post snap?
Yeah, that makes a little bit more pressure on me. I got to go through my reads a little bit faster and, you know, if need be, dump it off to the running back. So, I mean, if they drop all the guys deep and they're covering everybody, you know, past the line of scrimmage, then I got to get the ball to the running back.
As the only scholarship guy right now, how much do you have to kind of rein in the decision to run with? Mm-hmm.
My game hasn't changed whatsoever. Obviously, coaches told me to be careful in that way. But, you know, my game is my game, and I'm going to play it to my best ability. Obviously, I'm going to try to protect myself just because I know the situation. But, like I said, I'm going to keep playing the way I play.
What can you do as a player for a defense that disguises their coverage? How do you prepare for that?
We just do us. We don't need to focus on anybody else but ourselves. And for me, I just have to go through my reads. The receivers, they have to get the right depth, the right steps they have. We're not worried about anything else except for doing our job and doing it right.
What was the rest of your night like Friday?
Well, I got to see a lot of cameras pointed at me, of course. But I got to see my family and my friends, and that was a cool moment for me because I think, you know, everything's come to fruition. And, you know, I've been, you know, in the transfer portal, and it's a crazy situation, blah, blah, blah. You guys all know about it. But it is crazy to see, you know, Miguel out there and play and everything come full circle.
When you took the field today and you get the first team reps and preparing for a game that hadn't happened before, is it more meaningful? Is it different just in terms of what you can do with those reps?
Like I said, every day I come out here to prepare to the best of my ability and prepare like the starter. So it didn't matter if I was the third string a couple weeks ago or the first first string, second string, whatever it is, whatever the case may be this week. So every week is the same for me. I try to, you know, prepare the same way and prepare like I'm the starter regardless of the situation.
Let's go one more.
It's pretty cool to think about the fact that you were considering going to play somewhere else and represent another school, but you're here, where you wanted to be initially, and get to start at quarterback at USC. What does that mean to you, just being a USC starting quarterback?
It means a whole lot. I think the biggest thing is that I get to stay close to my family. I'm a big family-oriented guy, so that means a whole lot to me.